At this concentration camp in the Gotha area, the Germans starved, clubbed, and burned to death more than 4,000 political prisoners over a period of 8 months. A few captives survived by hiding in the woods. The camp is chosen for a high command inspection led by General Dwight D. Eisenhower. Also present are Generals Omar N. Bradley and George S. Patton. The 4th Armored Division of General Patton's 3rd Army liberated this camp early in April. The generals view the rack that was used by the Nazis to whip the inmates. They see the woodshed where lime-covered bodies are stacked in layers and the stench is overpowering. Former inmates demonstrate how they were tortured by the Nazis. American congressmen invited to view the atrocities were told by General Eisenhower, nothing is covered up. He had nothing to conceal. The barbarous treatment these people received in the German concentration camps is almost unbelievable. I want you to see for yourselves and be the spokesman for the United States. The general and his party next see the crude woodland crematory, actually a grill made of railway tracks. Here, the bodies of victims were cremated. Charred remains of several inmates still lay heaped atop the grill. Another group to visit the Ohrdruf camp is composed of local townspeople, including prominent Nazi party members. They'll be taken on a forced tour of the campsite by Colonel Hayden Sears, commander of the 4th Armored Division's Combat Command A, which captured Ohrdruf. A German medical major is compelled to accompany the townspeople. Sears stands by as the Nazis are informed that they must see all the horrors at the camp. First, the visitors view some 30 freshly killed bodies lying in the courtyard of the camp where they'd been shot on the evening preceding the entry of American tanks. These two are identified as slave labor bosses who maltreated, tortured, and killed their workers. Next, to the woodshed, which the Nazis are reluctant to enter, but Colonel Sears demands that they get a close-up look at the most gruesome of sights. Labor bosses enter. According to reports, the local Nazis continued their tour of the camp without apparent emotion. All denied knowledge of what had taken place at Ohrdruf. They are taken to the crematory 2 miles outside the camp, where the list of the atrocities is read for all to hear. 4,000 Ohrdruf victims are said to include Poles, Czechs, Russians, Belgians, Frenchmen, German Jews, and German political prisoners. The day before these Nazis visited the camp, the Burgermeister of Ohrdruf was forced to view the horrors. He and his wife were later found dead in their home, apparently suicides.